Hello students, so in this class we will see the multiplication of vectors. Okay, this is the second lecture of this chapter, motion in a plane. So here we will talk about multiplication of vectors. Okay, addition, subtraction we have already seen in the last lecture. So now multiplication. So before going to multiplication, I am telling one important thing, that thing we need. So resolution of vectors. Resolution of vector. Okay, here we will talk about only perpendicular resolution. Perpendicular resolution. Okay, what is this thing basically? In addition, we had done two vectors will be given. We have to add and we have to find the resultant vector. Here, that resultant vector will be given. Okay, we have to find the two perpendicular components. Okay. Like suppose this is a vector, it is given. Okay, suppose it is 8 newton, a force is given. Okay, and this is the coordinate system. This is x axis, this is y axis. Okay, clear? Then we have to find the component of this force along x axis and along y axis, because this is the resultant and this resultant one will be in between two components. Okay, so how to find the component? So one angle will be given. Suppose here this angle is given, okay, with x. Okay, so with x axis the angle is given theta. Okay, that means this component with which the angle is given, that component, so x component of the force, if x I am writing, x component of the force will be that vector, that means 8 newton into cos theta. So 8 cos theta, this much newton, this will be the component along x axis. Okay, this is the component, only length I have not put the vectors part. I am coming to the vector part. And the y component, the perpendicular component yb will be 8 sin theta n cap. So which one will be the cos theta with which the angle is given? Okay, and the other one will be sin theta component. Okay, so this F can be represented, F vector can be represented like this. Fx, this is along x axis, this is along x axis, and here we are introducing the unit vectors concept, because in multiplication of vectors, and also I will tell the addition and subtraction, how we can do it easily, that thing I will also tell. So here Fx I cap, what is I cap? I cap is the unit vector along x axis, then plus Fy j cap, unit vector along y axis. So it will be 8 cos theta I cap plus 8 sin theta j cap. Okay, these are unit vectors, and here we will take 3 unit vectors along 3 axes, x, y, z. And these 3 axes x, y, z are always perpendicular to each other. That means these 3 unit vectors I cap, j cap, and another unit vector is k cap along z axis. These 3 unit vectors will be perpendicular to each other. Clear? So this is the resolution of vector, perpendicular resolution, with which axis the angle is given, that component will be cos and the perpendicular component will be sin. Clear? Clear? Now come to the representation of vector using unit vector. Okay? So any vector A can be represented like this: ax I cap, ay j cap, and az k cap. Okay, here ax, ay, az are the components of this vector along x axis, along y axis, and along z axis. I cap, j cap, k cap are the unit vectors along x, y, z axis. So suppose this is x axis, y axis, and z axis, x, y, z. So this is I cap, this is j cap, and this is k cap. Their lengths are equal, and this is unit. Okay, unit length. For that reason, these vectors are called unit vectors, and they are always perpendicular to each other. Okay, clear? Clear. So if two vectors are given, I am giving one example. Suppose A is a vector. I am giving one example. Suppose 2i plus 3j minus 4k, and B is another vector, that is I plus j minus 5k. And you are asked to add these two vectors. Here in this process, addition is very simple. Okay, addition is very simple. So resultant, addition means we will get the resultant. So A plus B. Here what will you do? Just add the II component, then JJ component, then KK component. II component means 2 plus, no number is there, that means 1. Okay, plus 3 plus 1 plus minus 4 minus 5 k cap. Always put plus. Okay, in between the brackets always put plus sign. So 3i plus 4j minus 9k. This is the simple resultant vector. Okay, so in this way addition is very simple. Just add the components separately. Okay, if any components are not there, suppose here j is not there. Okay, I cap minus 5k cap, j is not there. You take the j component like this. So plus 0 j cap. If any unit vector is not there, then you will take 0 into that unit vector. Okay, clear? Clear. About subtraction, I am not talking here. About subtraction, I will tell in the relative velocity part, in the next part. Okay, so in this way, addition is very simple. Okay. Now, so this is the vector and I am representing the vector here. Suppose this is the vector, A vector. Okay, that A vector is making an angle with x axis, with y axis and with z axis also. So if any vector is given in this format, then how will you find the angle with x axis? Suppose you are asked, find the angle with x axis with this vector. So how to find the angle? So cos alpha, alpha is the angle with x axis, beta represents the angle with y axis, and gamma represents the angle with z axis. So cos alpha means, cos alpha will be x component by the magnitude of A vector. Okay, cos beta, angle with y axis, will be y component by magnitude of this vector, and cos gamma will be z component by magnitude of this vector. Clear? Clear. So this is angle alpha, this is angle alpha, this is beta, and this will be gamma. Clear? I am giving a simple example. Suppose this is the vector a equal to suppose 2i cap plus j cap plus 3k cap. Okay, okay. First, we have to find the angle with x axis. So, cos alpha will be what? The component along x axis. This is the component along x axis. So, 2 by its magnitude. How to find the magnitude? So, to find the magnitude, just take under root this component square. So 2 square plus with j, 1 is multiplied, so 1 square, and with k, 3 is multiplied, so 3 square. So it will be 4 plus 1 plus 9, it will be 9 plus 10 plus 4, 14. So it will be 2 by root over 14. Then you find alpha, alpha equal to cos inverse 2 by root 14. Clear? In the same way, you can find beta. Beta equal to cos inverse, cos inverse, then y component by magnitude. Y component is 1, magnitude is root over 14. And z component means angle with z axis. So gamma, so cos inverse, z component is 3, 3 by root over 14. Clear? Clear. So here we will write the components. Okay. Okay, students. Now come to multiplication. So in vectors, there are two types of multiplication. One is scalar multiplication and another is vector multiplication. Okay. Okay. They are two different types of multiplication. Scalar multiplication means after multiplying two vectors, we will get scalar. okay, like example work done, W equal to F dot S. In class 10 you have read that work means force into displacement in the direction of force, or displacement into force in the direction of displacement. That means W equal to here F dot A. Scalar product is written in this way. Two vectors, these are the two vectors, and in between there is a dot sign. So this multiplication is also known as dot product. Okay, dot product. Clear? Another is vector product. Vector product means we will multiply two vectors and we will get the vector back. Okay, that means here suppose I am giving one example, torque or moment of force. You have read in class 10. Okay, so that torque means R cross F. Okay, clear? Here this is the symbol of vector product, cross. Okay, for that reason this type of product is also called cross product. Okay, this type of vector is also called cross product. Clear? Clear? So this is dot product, this is cross product. Okay, after doing the dot product or scalar product, we will get scalar, means a particular number only. And after doing this kind of multiplication, we will get a vector. Okay, that means magnitude as well as direction. So first I am discussing about this dot product. Okay, so first scalar product. So suppose two vectors A and B. This is the symbol of scalar product. After doing this, we are getting a number that is suppose C. Okay, here I am not putting vector symbol because it is a number only. So A dot B equal to C. So the formula here, A dot B equal to A B cos theta. Okay, this is the magnitude of A vector, B is the magnitude of B vector, and theta is the smallest angle between A and B. Okay, theta is the smallest angle between A and B. Okay, so this here no vector symbol, so we are getting scalar. Okay, clear? So look at here, suppose this is a vector A and this is a vector B. This is the angle theta. Okay, so A dot B will be A B cos theta. If we write B dot A, then what you will get? B dot A. B dot A means again B A, and the angle between B and A. Okay, you can take this angle because we always go in this way, that means anticlockwise. Okay, you can take this angle, but at the end you will get this thing, like this angle is 360 degree minus theta. So here if we put this thing cos 360 degree minus theta, this angle will take the smallest angle, but the actual definition is the angle will be taken in anticlockwise direction. Okay, so here cos 360 minus theta, 360 minus theta is what? Fourth quadrant. In fourth quadrant cos is positive, so BA cos theta. So we are getting the same thing. So theta we can consider the smallest angle between A and B. Okay, so here BA cos theta or AB cos theta, they are same. Okay, so we can tell A dot B is equal to B dot A. Clear? Clear? So that means scalar product follows a commutative law. Commutative law. Okay? It follows the commutative law. Clear? 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 Okay. This product A dot B equal to AB cos theta, this product we use for this type of problem, like suppose theta, find the angle between A and B. Okay, then we will use basically this formula, A dot B equal to AB cos theta. Okay, I am coming like one two problem I am coming. So here first we will see few things, like the first point. Suppose after multiplying, after doing this scalar product, you are getting 0. A dot B equal to 0. Suppose you are getting A dot B equal to 0. That means what? Equal to AB cos theta. So that means we can tell cos theta equal to 0. When cos theta equal to 0? When theta equal to 90. So if we get A dot B equal to 0, that means we can tell A vector is perpendicular to B vector. Clear? So A dot B equal to 0 means without finding anything, we will write A vector is perpendicular to B vector. Clear? Clear? Okay. So now few problem we will see. I am erasing this part. Okay. So A dot B equal to AB cos theta. Now we will see how to find this dot product. Okay. Suppose A is given. Suppose 2y minus j cap. K is not here. And another B is given. B vector is 4j plus 3k. Here I is not there. Now A dot B. A dot B. How to find A dot B first? Okay, then we will find the angle. So A dot B. So A 2i minus j, k is not there, that means we will write 0 k cap dot B 4j k, that means I is not here. So 0 I cap plus 4j plus 3k. Okay. Here how to multiply? How to multiply? In dot product, we will simply multiply the ii component, then jj component, then kk component, and we will add them. So ii component, 2 into 0 plus minus 1 into 4, minus 1 into 4 plus 0 into 3. So we are getting 0 minus 4 plus 0. So we are getting basically minus 4. Okay. So this is the dot product of these two vectors. Clear? Clear? Okay. So after doing, this is the process in which we do the dot product. How? Multiply ii components, okay, plus multiply jj components, plus multiply kk components. Clear? Clear? So first we will find the dot product in this way. Then we will use that formula. So a dot b, that means we are getting here minus 4 equal to a b cos theta. Okay? So minus 4 equal to a, magnitude of a. Magnitude of a means how to find magnitude? Under root the square, sum of the square of the components. Okay? So under root 2 square plus minus 1 square. K is not there. Okay? So 2 square plus minus 1 square into root over b. Here I is not there. Forget about I. So 4 square plus 3 square. 4 square plus 3 square, then cos theta. Clear? So cos theta will be what? Minus 4 by, this is 1 plus 4, root 5 into 4 square plus 3 square, 16 plus 9, root over 25, that means 5. That means you are getting minus 4 by 5 root 5. Clear? Clear? After that you will find the theta. Okay? Theta will be cos inverse this. Okay? Cos inverse this, negative. Negative means cos negative will be in second quadrant or in third quadrant. Okay? Cos negative means second or third quadrant. We will take the smallest angle. So at the end theta will be what? Cos inverse. Cos inverse minus 4 by 5 root 5. Clear? This is the angle. In this way, we will find the angle between two vectors. So whenever you will get the question, find angle between two vectors. Two vectors are given in this format. Okay? In this format, I cap, j cap, k cap. Then we will use this process. Clear? First we will find the dot product. Then we will use this formula, a dot b equal to ab cos theta. A dot b means minus 4. ab cos theta, a is what? Magnitude. Magnitude means under root square of the components and add them. Clear? Into root over b. B means magnitude of b. So under root square of the components and add them into cos theta. Okay. So in this way we can find the angle. Okay. Another type of question is there. Suppose two vectors are given. You are asked so that they are perpendicular to each other. So here two vectors are given. A equal to I plus 2j plus 3k. And B is given 2i minus j. You are asked that show that these two vectors are perpendicular to each other. Then perpendicular to each other means, a dot b, we have to show a dot b equal to 0. Perpendicular to each other means a dot b dot product will be 0. Because theta equal to 90, cos 90 is 0. Okay, so we will check this thing. A dot b, we will write in this way. I 2j 3k dot 2i minus j minus j plus k is not there, 0 k. Clear? Clear. Then how to multiply? Just multiply the same components. Here 1 into 2. 1 into 2 plus 2 into minus 1. 2 into minus 1 plus 3 into 0. So 2 minus 2 plus 0. So 0. As you are getting 0, a dot b equal to 0. After that, you can tell that a and b vectors are perpendicular to each other. Clear? This is one type of problem. Another type of problem is there. Okay. Another type of problem is, suppose two vectors are given, a equal to 2i plus 3j plus 8k, and another vector b minus 4i plus 4j plus alpha k. Okay. And it is given that these two vectors are perpendicular to each other. It is given. These two vectors are perpendicular to each other. It is given. Find the value of alpha. Okay. It is given that these two vectors are perpendicular to each other. Find the value of alpha. Then how to find? So it is given perpendicular to each other means dot product is 0. Dot product is 0. So A dot B equal to 0. So write 2i 3j 8k dot minus 4i 4j alpha k equal to 0. So how to multiply? Just multiply the same components. 2 into minus 4, that is minus 8, plus 3 into 4, 12, plus 8 into alpha, 8 alpha equal to 0. So here you will get minus 8 plus 12, that means 8 alpha plus 4 equal to 0. So 8 alpha equal to minus 4, then alpha will be minus 4 by 8, that means minus half. Okay. So these are different kinds of problem related to scalar product. Now I am telling that thing, why we are multiplying in the same components, why we are not taking the different components, why? Okay, now I am coming to that thing. So we know that I cap, j cap, k cap, these three vectors, unit vectors, are perpendicular to each other. Okay, and their magnitudes are same. Clear? They are perpendicular to each other. That means if we take the same components I dot I, okay, we are multiplying two same components I dot I. So I dot I means what? I cap dot I cap. So I cap dot I cap means what? Magnitude of first I cap, that is one unit vector. Magnitude of second I cap, again one, into cos theta. Theta is the angle between two I cap. So what is the angle between two I caps? That will be 0 degree. Because two I caps, that means they are acting in the same direction. So 1 into cos 0, you will get 1. Okay, for that reason we are taking II component, JJ component and KK component. And if we take I dot J, I cap dot J cap, then first magnitude of I cap 1, magnitude of J cap 1 into cos theta. What is the angle between I cap and J cap? That is 90. So cos 90 degree. Cos 90 means 0. For that reason we are not getting the other components. Only the same components we are taking. Okay. So we can write I cap dot I cap, J cap dot J cap and K cap dot K cap equal to 1. Other components are 0. Clear? Clear? So this is the thing for which we are multiplying two same components. Okay? So this is scalar product. Now come to the vector product. Okay? Okay. Vector multiplication. Okay? So two vectors A and B. Here we are doing vector multiplication, that means cross product. So give this symbol cross. Okay? Then you will get what? You will get another vector. So C is the vector which is the multiplication of vector multiplication of A and B vectors. Okay? Clear? Clear. So here A and B vectors can lie in any plane. Okay? Suppose these are this is A vector and this is B vector. Okay? Because we know that any two vectors will always lie along a particular plane, along the same plane. Okay? Now what will be the direction of this C vector? What will be the direction of this C vector? Okay? So here, for finding the direction, we will use this screw rule. Okay? That means we will use this thing. Okay? So we are multiplying here A cross B. So first A vector. So we'll put our four fingers, these four fingers, along A vector. Clear? Then we will curl our these four fingers towards B. Okay? And from A to B. A to B. First A vector, then B vector. So this thumb will give the direction of C vector. Clear? So here, look at this. A cross B, then this is C vector, means this is the C vector. Clear? This is the C vector. Look at this. So this C vector is perpendicular to this plane. Perpendicular to this plane means C vector is perpendicular to A vector and B vector. So after vector multiplication, the vector will get, that will always be perpendicular with the component vectors. C is perpendicular to A and as well as C is perpendicular to B. Clear? A and B may or may not be perpendicular. Here A and B are not perpendicular vectors. There is an angle which is less than 90 degree. But the C vector, okay, which is the multiplication vector, that will be perpendicular to A and as well as with B. Clear? Clear? That means we will get A dot C equal to 0 and B dot C equal to 0. Clear? 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 Okay? Now, C equal to A cross B, it is coming like this. But if we take B cross A, then what will happen? B cross A. That means, first along B, we will put our four fingers along B, okay? Then we will curl our four fingers towards A. So this thumb is going now inside the boat, okay? It is entering into the boat. That means, B cross A is entering into the boat. A cross B is coming out of the boat. So they are not equal vectors. So that means this will be a different vector. Suppose C prime. Okay. So these two vectors, A cross B and B cross A, they are not equal. Okay. They are anti-parallel. Okay. A cross B and B cross A, they are anti-parallel. Clear? Clear? So, here these C prime vector and C vector, they will act along the same line, but not in the same direction. So, here A cross B, simply we can tell that A cross B is not equal to B cross A. Okay? So, here vector multiplication does not follow the commutative law. Okay? It does not follow the commutative law, but the scalar product A dot B equal to B dot A. So scalar product follow the commutative law. Vector product does not follow. Okay? So here we will see this vector product using some example. Okay? And one small thing that I want to tell, that is formula. First I am telling the formula. So A cross B will be what? A, B, then sin theta here. sin theta into n cap, because it is a vector. So n cap will represent the unit vector along the direction of A cross B. Okay, so n cap is the unit vector, and what will be the direction of unit vector? It will be perpendicular to the plane containing A vector and B vector. Clear? So this is the small formula of vector product, but basically we will not use in many cases. For finding the angle, we use basically that scalar product concept. Okay, this thing will not basically use. For simple question, we can use, like I am giving one question. So suppose magnitude of A cross B equal to AB. Magnitude of A cross B equal to AB. So what will be the angle between A and B? Okay, so magnitude of A cross B is AB, means magnitude means forget about this n cap part, because this tells about the direction. Magnitude do not tell about the direction, only value we need. So A cross B equal to magnitude A cross B means we will write AB sin theta equal to AB. Now AB, AB cancel out, sin theta equal to 1, so theta equal to 90 degree. Okay, so mod A cross B equal to AB means theta will be 90 degree. Clear? Now come to the numerical related to vector multiplication. Okay, so we will understand this vector multiplication using one example. So suppose I am taking one example. Suppose A equal to 3i minus 4j plus 5k, and B is another vector, that is minus 2i minus j minus 3k. Okay, how to find the cross product or vector product? So A cross B. Here remember that A cross B is not equal to B cross A. I have written there. Okay, A cross B is not equal to B cross A. Okay, so A cross B, how to find? So we will find A cross B using determinant. So first write, in the first row, write in the unit vectors I cap, J cap, K cap. Clear? Then first A vector, that means we will write those numbers which are related to A vectors. That means below I will write this component, below J will write this component, always put with sign, and below K will put this component plus 5. Then B vector, in the third row write the components of B vector. So B below I cap minus 2, below J cap nothing is there, that means 1, so minus 1, and below K cap minus 3. Clear? Now how to do? So first put I cap, then give bracket. Okay, so first I am taking I cap means the row and column containing I cap vector cover those rows and column. Okay, cover that row, this row and this column containing I cap vector. Then the remaining terms are here. These are the remaining terms. Clear? Now how to multiply? First multiply these two. That means minus 4 into minus 3, that is plus 12. Then always put, after multiplying these two, put minus sign. Then multiply these two. 5 into minus 1, that means minus 5. So minus 5. Okay, clear? Then first before I cap plus sign, before J cap minus sign, before J cap minus sign, plus minus, before K cap again plus, plus minus plus, plus minus plus. Okay, again. Okay, so we will cover that row and column containing J vector. Okay, so now we will cover which one, this row and this column. Okay, this row and this column. Okay, the remaining terms are 3, 5, minus 2, minus 3. Again we will multiply in the same order. First this, 3 into minus 3, minus 9, then put minus sign. After multiplying first two numbers, put minus sign. Then multiply these two numbers, these two. Minus 2 into 5, minus 10. So bracket, minus 10. Two consecutive minus signs are there. For that reason, I have given here a bracket. Okay, clear. Now k cap. So plus, minus, before k cap, again plus sign. Clear. Now, cover the row and column containing k cap. So cover this column and this row. The remaining terms are these are the remaining terms. Okay, again multiply in the same order. First this, minus 3, then put minus sign. Okay, then multiply these two, that means minus 2 into minus 4, that is plus 8. Okay, clear. Now just calculate. So minus 12 minus minus plus 5, so 12 plus 5, 17 I cap. Minus 9 minus minus plus 10, so 10 minus 9, so 1 into minus j, so minus j cap simply. And for this minus 3 minus 8, minus 3 minus 8, you will get minus 11 k cap. Okay, so this is the answer of this cross product. So after doing this vector multiplication or cross product, we are getting a vector. This is a vector, I cap, j cap, k caps are there, so this is a vector. Okay, and I have already told that this vector will be perpendicular to A and as well as with B. Okay, so we can check it, we can check anyone. So suppose this is C vector, we are getting this, this is a C vector. So whether this C vector is perpendicular to A or B, that we will check. So that means A dot C will be 0. So we'll check this. So A means 3i minus 4j plus 5k dot 17i minus j, 17i minus j minus 11k. Clear? Dot product means we will multiply the same components, similar components. So 3 into 17 plus first 3 into 17. 3 into 17 is 51. Okay. Then minus 4, here minus 1 plus minus 4 into minus 1. So plus 4. Clear? Again plus 5 into minus 11. 5 into minus 11, minus 55. So here 55 minus 55, we are getting 0. That means we can tell C vector is perpendicular to A vector. In the same way, you can check B dot C. You will get 0. Okay. That means C vector is perpendicular to A vector and as well as B vector. Okay. Clear. Sometimes you can get this type of question, that find the perpendicular vector which is perpendicular to A and B. Okay. Find a vector which is perpendicular to A vector and B vector. That means basically you have to find the cross product or vector product. Okay. Sometimes you can get this type of question. Find the unit vector which is perpendicular to A and B vector. Find the unit vector. Okay. Which is perpendicular to A and B. So for perpendicular vector, first we will do this cross multiplication. We will get this type of thing. Okay, so basically suppose for these two vectors we are getting this thing. Now we have to find the unit vector. This is the vector which is perpendicular to A and B. Now we have to find the unit vector which is perpendicular to A and B. That means basically we have to find the unit vector of this one, this C vector, unit vector of this C. How to find the unit vector? So for finding unit vector, we will use that formula. Vector by its magnitude. So suppose this is unit vector c cap. So vector by its magnitude. Clear? Vector means this. So we'll write this 17i minus j minus 11k by its magnitude. Magnitude means, how to find magnitude? Under root square of the components and add them. So 17 square plus minus 1 square plus minus 11 square. Whatever the value you will get here, this vector by this, that is the unit vector. Okay, that is the unit vector which is perpendicular to A and as well as with B. Clear? 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 Okay. So, this is basically the vector multiplication. Clear? Okay. In class 10, you had seen torque equal to basically the cross product. Okay. Here, remember that R cross F and F cross R, they are not equal. Okay. R cross F is the torque formula, not F cross R. Okay, do not write F cross R. Okay, clear, clear. And another is angular momentum, L, that is R cross P. Okay, angular momentum is equal to R cross P. This thing you will basically read in chemistry. Okay, in physics you will also read in angular momentum chapter. Okay, angular motion chapter in 11. Okay, clear. So these are few parts. Now I am telling one two more example. Okay, take a short example, that is suppose magnitude of A cross B is equal to A dot B. Magnitude of A cross B is equal to A dot B. Okay, what is the angle between A and B? Okay, clear. So here magnitude of A cross B, that means what will be the formula? AB sin theta, no n cap. And A dot B, that means AB cos theta. Clear? Clear? AB, AB cancel out. Now sin by cos, sin theta by cos theta will be 1. That means tan theta equal to 1. So theta will be what? Tan of which angle equal to 1? 45 degree. That means pi by 4. Clear? These are short questions. Clear? Okay. Now come to very small things, okay, but very very important. That is, in scalar product, we have taken I cap, J dot J cap, and K cap dot K cap equal to 1. But if we take the cross product of these terms, that means I cap, J cap, cross J cap, and K cap, cross K cap will give us 0. Okay, I cap, cross I cap, that means sin 0, 1 into sin 0, this one, magnitude into sin theta. Okay, for J cap also and for K cap also. So, for this reason, I cap, J cap, K cap will be 0. But the other components will remain here. That means I cap cross J cap. Okay. So here, suppose this is I cap, this is J cap, and this is K cap. So if we go anti-clockwise, I cap cross J cap cross K cap. Okay. If we go like this. Okay. Then I cap cross J cap will give us the third unit vector. Okay. So that means I cap cross J cap will give us basically K cap. If we go in this way, that means anti-clockwise, then I cap cross J cap will give us K cap. But J cap cross I cap is not K cap. J cap cross I cap is not K cap. It is minus K cap. Okay. Clear? So, whenever we are interchanging these two vectors, that means A cross B and B cross A, that means two vectors, the vector product of two vectors, A cross B, okay. And if we take B cross A, first B then A, then the after multiplication we will get two vectors which are acting exactly in the opposite direction, okay. That means they are anti-parallel vectors. In the same way, I cross A, J cross K will give us I cap. K cross I will give us J vector. So remember these three, then if it is reversed, then you will automatically find. Clear? Clear? If I cross I cap cross K cap, I cap cross K cap. First I, then K. Then it will be minus J. Okay. So remember in this way, I J K. J K I. K I J. Okay. Remember these three. Others you can automatically find. Clear? So these are all about the scalar and vector products. And initially I have told about the representation of vector in terms of unit vectors and how to add two vectors, two, three vectors, many vectors we can add in this way easily. Okay, because here you do not have to find the angle, here you do not have to use the formula root over a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta, those things we do not have to use. Just add the same similar components, add the similar components. Okay, so we can easily add 3, 4, 5, 6, how many vectors will be given, we can easily add. Clear? So these are all about thus vector multiplications. Okay.